back to my channel. My name is Melody. You can call me Mel. And today we are starting Control. Now, if you haven't seen my last video, let me give a little bit of explanation. I started doing a Miles Morales playthrough, and I was having so much fun. I loved it so much. But when I did a second stream, like I'm doing right now, I made a mistake. I started a new Twitch channel, which I will plug somewhere on this video, and it was going great. It was a great stream, but unfortunately, I forgot to turn on saving VODs. You know, save the entire stream onto the channel. That's what I use to edit and create these episodes for you all. Well, unfortunately, because I lost all the footage, 4 hours of Miles Morales was gone. I played 4 hours of it. I was two-thirds through the story. And it's just gone. It's gone. Unfortunately. Yeah. So I had to come up with a backup plan. And today we're going to be playing Control. This was going to be my second series, but technically this will be my first. So I'm really looking forward to this. I only played about 20 to 30 minutes about a year ago. And I was so in awe of it, and I knew I wanted to make a gameplay channel in the future. So I stopped. I was like, I gotta do this for the streams. And yeah, now here we are. I cannot wait to get back into this. I barely remember what I played. I just remember what I saw was, oh my god, this is so creative and cool. And yeah, that should be about it. I hope you all enjoy me playing Control. I hope you are enjoying the channel so far, despite the hiccup. And I hope you continue to join me on this journey as I show myself to the world as a trans woman playing on YouTube. That's still nerve-wracking to me. It's especially hard when I'm doing it live like this. It's making the heart go just a little bit. Anyway, let's get right into it, guys. Hope you all like the new dress. Something I just got that was happy with it.
This is gonna be weirder than usual. Can't be helped. You called me. So here I am. I know I shut you out sometimes. I'm always glad to hear from you. It's just that I get my hopes up. So many times it's led to nothing. I found nothing. It's like we live in a room and there's a poster on the wall. We stare at it and we think that's the whole world. The room and the poster. The picture's something nice. A landscape, a famous person. Like in that movie. What is it called? The prison movie. The room's a cell, and the picture, it's different for each of us. It can be beautiful or terrible. But we're all transfixed. But it's all a lie. Something to distract us from the truth. They're lying to us. We're lying to ourselves. The room's not the world. The world is much bigger and much stranger. There's a hole hidden behind that poster that leads to the real world. We all feel safe in that room. But sometimes something crawls out from behind the poster. And the ones that see it happen freak out and try to forget what they saw. I'm here. Why did you bring me here?
Hello?
confused yet?
Anyone here?
That's this game. This game is confusing. I remember that. Reminder, certain objects are not allowed inside the bureau. Recent incidents have this necessitated an issued reminder on prohibited materials. Unauthorized weapons, pagers, laptops, smartwatches, smartphones, smart gaming devices, anything smart. You could have started with that. Number 2, pencils. Okay. Any objects considered iconic representations of an archetypal concept, rubber ducks, ketchup bottles, etc. All material under Bureau investigation is to be brought in through the private entrances. If you see any lobby personnel in breach of these policies, please notify your supervisor immediately. Interesting. I won't be reading through every piece of paper. I know some players do that. It's just not my thing. I'm not a great reader. I mean, I can read. I just can't read out loud very well. I'm slightly dyslexic. This game is so gorgeous. I mean, if you had told me this had come out on the PS5 instead of the PS4, I'd have believed you.
Federal Bureau of Control. All these years, I've been looking for them, and they were hiding in plain sight.
Hi, Shin. Welcome back. Y'all want to pause and look at that? Go ahead. Oh, I'm good, Shin. Just not in a very celebratory mood.
Excuse me.
You know what I mean? It's 4th of July right now, and it's just not my thing. Especially after events that have transpired recently. Who are you?
There you are. You are here about the job. Janitor's assistant. You need to go to the interview. Go that way to the elevator.
Thanks. Elevator that way. Got it.
Very good. I'm Ahti, the janitor, by the way. You'll work for me. You can say I sent you. If they don't hire you, Elevate. There be work for the axe. Take them behind the sauna, you mallard.
I've done enough night shift loner jobs to know it makes us come off weird. Ahti the janitor is a friendly face in my book. This seal. I saw it a long time ago. I keep seeing it in my dreams.
The whole aesthetic of this game is so interesting. It reminds me... I don't know, it's like if Stephen King made Stranger Things. I don't know how to describe it.
The cell and the poster. I was 11 years old the first time I saw behind the poster. They told me I imagined it. I've been trying to pull it down ever since. Will you help?
I will certainly try, honey. I don't know who I am. I don't know why you're talking to me like I'm a person. Oh, credits. Game's over. Well, that was fun.
Did I lose you there for a moment? You know what's on my mind. My baby brother, Dylan. 17 years since the men of this bureau took him.
Woo! Here's the sound. Okay. Coffee maker's having a seizure. Can I turn this off, please? Okay, let's move on. Get away from the noise. What was that noise?
Shit. Shit, shit, shit. You want me to pick it up? The murder weapon? Really?
Oh, that's right. This is very Resident Evil with the, labyrinth-like map.
Poster.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. Now, the service weapon is, of course, a prime example of an OOP, a very powerful one, ingrained in the Bureau's DNA, a key component in our prime candidate program. Come out of that Russian roulette a winner, and you, you're it.
Look at this place. Where am I?
I don't know, honey. I don't know why you asked me this, because I'm as confused as you are. Oh, you're creepy. Hello. Goodbye.
The same gun.
Thank you, Royce. Much appreciated.
Okay, now I have a gun.
I'm usually not that bad at aiming. Okay. You know what? I feel ashamed right now. happening?
Something's coming. This threat. An attack. Duty as director. Keep the Bureau safe.
Did you hear that? It's the dead man. Right after the pyramid spoke to me, and it was just noise, and I understood every word. And this gun's alive. You know what? I'm happy. Happy to be here. Things have quieted down outside. Is it safe to go?
Okie dokie, if you say so.
Nope.
Yeah, how about no? Let's just set our new desk. You know, if we're director, I mean, this is where we belong. what was that? I don't want to go out there. That's scary.
You can't let this happen. 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 You stopped it. You. Oh, thank you. That was horror.
Go away. Sir, I am telling you to go away. Don't like you. Hiss card.
Secure line of communication. Guide us. Reach the hotline.
The hotline, says the dead man. Okay.
I love the different visual effects for everything. There's lots of color, but it's also very monochromatic in many ways as well. Oh, that's satisfying. Weapon mod. Can you all hear those voices? that's creepy. Gives me, like, a combination of Half-Life and Portals. Funny, because they're the same people, but still, it's like they combined Aperture Science with Black Mesa. And that's not a bad thing. That makes for a neat aesthetic with a little hint of Fallout's Vault Tech.
sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss, burrowing into everything in this place. Is the hiss your enemy? Alright.
I don't know who I am, honey. I really don't.
That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over.
Again, if you all want to read it, just go ahead and pause. I'm sorry. I just don't have the patience for it because of my dyslexia.
Something in the way.
Okay. Oh, no. Easier to not aim down the sights.
Must cleanse control points. An enemy. Spreading.
Cleanse the control point. What does that mean? Let me fix it.
That reminds me a little bit of Inception. There's a lot of different sci-fi films and games here.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
We did it.
Hello. Can you hear me? Are you with us? With the Bureau? Are you still sane?
I can't tell you how happy I am to talk to somebody sane.
The feeling's mutual. I'm Pope, Emily Pope, Dr. Darling's assistant.
My turn. Should I lie?
Jesse Faden. I'm just visiting.
I should have lied.
Oh, shit. You're the new director. Hold on. We're coming out.
Director Faden. Call me Jesse. Okay, Jesse. I'm Emily. Look, somehow, this hostile force, this
hiss?
That works? Somehow the hiss managed to infiltrate the building without any warning.
And just like that, my name for it is official. The hiss. Like the sound of poison gas leaking in.
We're in full lockdown. It seems to have spread everywhere and to everyone not protected by an HRA. And, extraordinarily, you. You are the director, and that makes you special by definition. Trench is no longer the director, obviously. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much. This whole situation is just a lot.
Yeah, could you explain it to me a little bit?
Trench is dead. Shot. I found his body. And the gun.
Did I tell her it looked like a suicide?
The service weapon. Also, and this can sound crazy, but he keeps appearing to me, saying things. It's hard to make out, but he told me to cleanse the control point, push the hiss out. The whole room shifted around.
You did that? And you entered the building when it was already in the lockdown, before you became the new director?
How?
I'm not ready to tell her about you yet.
A janitor let me in.
Well, I...
This is fucking unbelievable. It's... I can't even... Look, Jesse, I have a million questions, and you probably have a million more.
Like, do you know my brother Dylan? Not yet.
But there's something I need to ask you to do first. If you can cleanse a control point, then you can maybe cure those infected or possessed by the Hiss. Because if that's possible, our options are very different.
Emily Pope. I don't know her, but I like her already. She's the opposite of the faceless agency I've blamed for what happened to me for so long. But I can't trust her yet. Or rather, the Bureau she's a part of.
Yes. I can try.
I'm speaking for you, of course. We can try it together. Okay. You with me? We did it before. Pushed the Hiss out.
She looks kind of funny like that. Come on, let's help you.
It didn't work. The Hiss has burrowed too deep. Ripping it out rips them apart.
Ooh, outfits?
We need to make a plan, Jesse.
Oh, so. Oh, well. Maybe later.
I can't cleanse them. I saw. It was worth a shot. Thank you, Director. Jesse.
I'm gonna tell her why I'm here. I'll risk it.
Listen. The Bureau was involved in an incident in my hometown, Ordinary, 17 years ago.
Ordinary.
The Bureau came in and covered the whole thing up. I've been looking for this place for a long time.
That's enough. Maybe that's too much already. I can't tell her about Dylan and the rest yet.
I've seen mentions of an Altered World event case dealing with Ordinary. You were at Ground Zero as a child? It was one of the big ones, and before my time. And very classified. I can try to dig out some old files for you. My boss, Casper Darling, would know, but he's missing. I think he knew this was coming, or suspected. He came up with the HRAs, the Hadron Resonance Amplifiers. I think they're what saved us. A few of us. And Director Trench would know.
Trench. The ghost, or whatever he is. He mentioned something called the hotline. Said I should find it.
It's another object of power, like the gun. An old Bakelite telephone. A direct line of communication between the Director and the board. Maybe he can talk to you more clearly through that. I mean, Trench has years and years of experience. He might know how to destroy the Hiss.
Where is the hotline?
It's kept in the communications department through the mailroom. It's part of this sector, so we can access it even with the lockdown in place. We'll get the door open for you.
Okay, that's my next stop.
That's Tomasi's department. He's head of communications. I don't think he had an HRA. He kind of made a point about not wearing one earlier. Keep an eye out.
They call me the Director. But that's not me. I'm not a director type. I'm not a leader.
Not yet.
Why am I here? I think you already know. Yes, I came for my brother, but there are other reasons too. I said I was looking for answers, but I might never understand them. I'm not looking for proof. This is already it. More than enough. No matter what they told me all those years, I know it's real now. I didn't imagine this. I want to be a part of this world. What scares me shitless is that I finally found it. Only to see the hiss destroy it all.
It's so bizarre. It's like you're thrown right into the middle of, like, the second act of a story. You know what I mean? Instead of easing you in, they're just like,
look, I know this is all new to you.
Here you are.
Don't hesitate to ask me anything you want to know. There are no... The hotline should be in the communications department. Where did the hiss come from? I'm not sure. You said the hiss was here when you entered. Did you see anything like that outside before you came in?
No. No, just inside.
The source is internal, then. See, the oldest house is a sprawling complex with openings to other places as well. I don't even know where to start looking. But in the context, it's good news. The lockdown holds. The hiss escaping the building would be the end. Pretty shitty world out there, if you ask me, but I wouldn't want the hiss to destroy it.
It can be, Emily. Unfortunately.
You mentioned the oldest house. What is it?
This building, the Bureau headquarters, the oldest house, is a shifting place. You've seen it. It transcends its physical limits.
I've been to New York a few times. How didn't I notice this place?
It's an attribute of the building. This is a place of power. The oldest house doesn't like attention, so unless you're purposely trying to find it, you don't. Which is perfect for us. The work we do here is essential, but unstable. The Bureau prefers not to be noticed. And we need strong walls to make sure nothing gets out.
So without you, I never would have found the front door.
Okay. This trench guy. I keep hearing him in my head. Is he a ghost? Haunting me?
I doubt we're talking about a ghost in the traditional sense. But an echo, maybe. See, if he was killed by the service weapon, your gun, maybe it's his final thoughts recorded by the bullet in his brain, like a deep space probe sending back data. But that's just a hypothesis on my part. I'd need the gun to research it. But you better hold on to that, given the circumstances.
I think I will. Yeah.
So it's very, I wonder how much of this is fantasy and how much of it is sci-fi. I know they can kind of blend, I know that, but here there's no, like, indication of either. It matches both.
Can you tell me what an object of power is exactly? This is all, well, new to me.
Don't worry, I love going over the basics. So objects of power are mundane objects that house paranatural energies and have developed a link to the astral plane and can thus be controlled, which is what differentiates them from altered items, which are still housings of paranatural forces, but are more volatile and cannot be bound in the peri-utilitarian sense. Got it?
Did she memorize this? Got it. Thanks.
Yes. I understood that 100%.
So HRA stop you from becoming Hiss?
Wait, it seems that way. I mean, I hadn't even heard of an HRA until a few weeks ago when Dr. Darling started handing them out. Well, I began analyzing mine as soon as I got it. I mean, each one seems to emit a powerful short-range frequency way beyond anything I've ever seen.
Doesn't the timing seem suspicious?
I thought that too. Dr. Darling usually likes to unveil his latest breakthrough in big presentations. With these, he just passed them out. Yeah, his behavior makes me wonder what exactly he knew.
Alright. So Sounds good to me.
Thanks, Emily. I'm sure I'll have more questions soon.
Just let me know.
So I gotta blush about the visuals again. The facial animations? Mwah. Just, wow. I thought, games like Detroit and Injustice 2 had some of the best. I think this has better. I'm a little impressed, actually. Like, talk to him. So, I have to get to... hold on, everyone. I'm gonna change my, face cam location. It's a little, obstructive right now. Don't mind me. Okay, that should be good. I have to enter communications, which is over there. Okay, so if I... Oh boy, yeah, this is very Resident Evil. There's a jukebox in a cell. Okay.
Say what?
Oh no, maybe look for the big glowing thing. Yeah. Oh, and arrows help too. Ladies and gentlemen, I am smart. I promise.
There it is again. Our welcome message.
Okay, what is that? Is that coral? Okay, I guess we're not going in there. Okay, I guess that's not the case either.
This is a load of barnacles.
We're not stupid.
There it is again. A welcome message.
Ah. didn't even see this. Thank you, Matt. Handle these hands! Ah. Faster. Then we must cleanse this place of the Batman filter. Away now. No, I'm sorry. We gotta talk about what in the actual fuck did I just witness? I'm speechless. I got nothing. That's not gonna leave my brain for a while.
Communications. We're on the right track.
Oh, that's a lot of blood. And it's been dragged off. Poor guy. Let's just see what's in the shelter. I'm sure it's much more pleasant. don't know what these things do. That scripts again. I don't know. Okay. I'm gonna go this way.
Object of power.
Oh god!
We need to find it.
Oh no, leave me alone. I'm a good person! I will be your friend! Shatter, whatever that is. Run! You didn't get me.
When I'm here, it's like the channel's been changed. The boards in charge here, their pyramids in the bureau seal. Are they really the ones pulling the strings? I'm not their director. I'm no one's director.
Okay. That seems like a good place to leave off this first episode. I've been recording a little bit longer than I intended. I'm gonna keep going, keep recording more for you all, but for this first episode, I hope you all enjoy it. This was a lot of fun. This is pretty much all that I played, for the most part. Still just as wild and crazy as I remember it being. I look forward to more, because it's an interesting story that, like, jumped right into the middle of it. You know, there's no exposition, no explanations, just go. And it's a bit refreshing. It's confusing as hell, but, you know, sometimes we need this kind of experience, you know? Just for fun. Anyway, hope you all enjoyed this episode. Make sure to click that like button if you did, subscribe for more episodes, and if you click that bell icon, you can be updated when I upload, and I'll see you all next time. Peace out!